Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And this video we are going to talk about the diseases of bone. So without further ado, let's get started. Back to another 10 in 10 series where we cover each topic under 10 headings in 10 minutes. And today's topic is the Paget's disease, which is also known as osteitis deformans. As the name suggests, this is a deformity of the bone. That means deformity of the osteitis of the bone, that is weakening of the bone. There is deformity of the bone. And before we get started, make sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future notifications. So, Paget's disease was first reported by Sir James Paget in 1877. Paget disease is relatively uncommon disease of the bone, and what we see in the Paget's disease is that there are phases of bone resorption as well as there are phases of bone deposition. So, there is bone remodeling which takes place in same particular area. So that in one specific bone there is first resorption going on, then there is deposition going on. Now this deposition is not the normal deposition, this is abnormal deposition. So there is not a normal pattern of the deposition we see. So what do we see? We see that there is repositioning, there is resorption as well as there is deposition of the bone. So this is the Paget's disease, most commonly seen in the old people, and the exact etiology is not known, and that is the reason I have not mentioned it. But it can be genetic abnormalities, it can be defective in the connective tissue metabolism, it can be any autoimmune disease. So what do we see in the Paget's disease? We see that the size of the skull increases. Most of the patient with a Paget disease, they complain that their hat size increases. So whenever they wear their old hat, this hat doesn't fit in their size. So that is the most common characteristic feature the patient complain. And second most common feature is that most of the patient, they often complain of pain. They often complain of that specific bone pain, a deep and aching bone pain they complain of, and also there is swelling of the bone. There is deformity in the stress bearing areas. There is deformity of the bone which takes place. Paget's disease most commonly involves the men population as compared to the female population. So there are phases. Initially there is osteolytic phase, initially there is a resorption of the bone which takes place, and then later on stages are with the osteoblastic stage or the sclerotic stage, that is wherein the deposition takes place. So this is how the bone first resorb and then there is a deposition which takes place. The patient sometimes they feel that the pain is there. So the pain is too much that the patient is sometimes even unable to move the specific part. So that is a very disheartening, because the patient won't be able to move even the affected organ. Many cases this is asymptomatic, but most of the cases there is deep sitting pain, deep dull aching pain which a patient suffers from. And there is also stress bearing area, we see that deformity of the bone takes place. Stress bearing area like the spine, like the pelvis, so where all the loads come. And what do we see there? That the weight bearing areas of the body, they have got the bow like deformity. So because of the pressure which is coming off our weight, our body weight, so that is the reason weight bearing areas, they have this bow like, not straight, bone are not straight, the bone are like bow like. So there is also bow like deformity in these particular bone where there is a weight bearing area, where there is pressure coming, so there comes the deformity, bow-like deformity which occurs in the bone. And the typically appearance we call the monkey-like stance. And moreover, the patient has got, because see, legs, we put so much of body weight on the legs, and this is the reason even the legs bend. So sometimes the people are seen with the waddling gait, so they cannot walk properly, so they'll be like kind of a limping. So they have got the waddling gaits. Also in the Paget's disease we see that the face of the patient is not normal. So that is Leonitis Ossia. So that is Leontiasis Ossia. So Leontiasis Ossia is when there is a lion-like face, when there is a lion-like appearance. So this is a lion, as you can see, Leontiasis Ossia. So because of this, the patient's face usually, often it looks like the lion face. Also we see that there is grotesque appearance, and this grotesque appearance of the face is basically, grotesque means something absurd, something bizarre. So not the normal face, the patient actually face looks like the ugly face, because there is so much of deformity going on the face also. So when the facial bones are involved, then the patient has got severe deformity of the face. So the all the maxilla, mandible, they are not proper in shape. Because of the deformity, the patient face looks like Leontiasis face, that is the lion-like face. So Leontiasis Ossia is a feature of the Paget's disease. Also what happens, because there is enlargement of the skull, when the skull size increases, as you can imagine what happens when the skull size increases, so all these foramens, they will get closed, right? So all these foramens, they will get closed, and because of that there will be compression of the nerves, compression of the cranial nerves, there can be facial paralysis, there can be blindness, headache, deafness, all these things we often see the patient complains of. There is enlargement of the skull because of that, there is difficulty in wearing the old hat. So all these things we see. Dental, if we look at, so oral we see that there is flattening of the palate, there is retroclination of the incisors, there is diastema, malocclusion, and there is palatoversion of the posterior teeth. So all these things we see that when the maxilla, see maxilla is more common, more often involved in the Paget's disease compared to the mandible. So more often that maxilla is affected. So what do we see? That the palate is not in a normal shape. There is the palate, the shape of the palate is more like a flat shape. Also we see that generalized hypocementosis. So when you look at the OPG of these patients, the Paget's disease, see, if the mandible is involved, then the bone looks like the black beard appearance of the scan. If we are doing the scan in case of monostotic, see, only the mandible is involved sometimes. When monostotic form is when only one bone is involved, not multiple bones. So in case of mandible is involved, in case of monostotic, in that case when we see the bone scan, the bone mandible appears like a black beard, as if the mandible is the patient is wearing a black beard. So OPG we see that there is a generalized hypercementosis. There is hypercementosis which involves the entire dentition. Also sometimes we see ankylosis, we see the obliteration of the pedial space, and also we see the loss of lamina dura. So all these things also we see in the OPG. So what about the radiographically? Radiographically we see that because there is resorption going on, there is deposition going on because of this remodeling process. The bone, there are patches, radio opaque patches, because when the new bone is forming, right? So there are new patches which are coming up. So the bone looks like the cotton wool appearance. As we see the wool of the cotton, so it looks like same. So there are patches of radio opacities which are present in the bone, and that is why we see the cotton wool appearance. Histopathologically we see that there is rapid resorption, and there is subsequently there is deposition also going on. So once what we see that, suppose in this part of the bone there is a resorption going on, and immediately there is bone deposition. So we see that there are reversal lines. We see multiple reversal lines. We see multiple resting lines. So this irregular pattern of the reversal and the resting lines, it produces a jigsaw puzzle or the mosaic pattern of the bone. So we see that the affected bone, it becomes thin, it becomes sclerosed, and the medullary cavity, it becomes obliterated. So all these things we see. So because of the irregular pattern of these reversal lines and the resting lines, we see the jigsaw pattern or the mosaic bone pattern. This is very important. You must remember that the mosaic bone pattern or the jigsaw pattern is seen in the Paget's disease. When we do the lab investigation, we see that because there is remodeling going on, so that is why increase in the alkaline phosphatase we see in those particular cases. So, increase in the pathological fracture we see in case of Paget's disease because the bone becomes weak. There is severe weakening also of the bone takes place. So, most of the time there are pathologic fracture which happens, and because there is deformity, as I have told you in the beginning itself, that there is weakening and there is deformity of the bone which takes place. So, some people recently, some investigator says that calcitonin suppresses the bone resorption and bone deposition rates in this particular disease. But sometimes there may be surgery which is required for this. Unfortunately, few patients of the Paget's disease, they can transform into the osteosarcoma, which is again the tumor of the bone. So this is about the Paget's disease. You have to remember this, that the Paget's disease, radiographically we see that there is cotton wool appearance. Then histopathologically we see jigsaw puzzle or mosaic bone pattern. And when we look at the patient, there is going to be increase in the skull size. Also we see there is a bizarre skull, there is an absurd skull, which we call absurd face. And there is a bizarre ugly face we see. So that is the grotesque appearance of the face we see, and also we see the loin like face, that is we call leontiasis ossea. So this is about the Paget's disease. If you have enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Also you can comment in the comment section below, and there is a link in the description box below to support me on Patreon as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys. Till then, keep reading, keep learning, stay motivated. I'll see you soon in the next video.